Motion Device from their album Eternalize. That was Orpheus. This is Farmore Mark Jabroni. You are listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMRFM. The thought of using molten copper heated to over 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit conjures up thoughts of ancient torture devices. But in the hands of one of our favorite YouTube channels, the Slow Mo Guys, that dangerous liquid metal can be used to create a beautiful display that combines art and science. The latest video from Dan and Gavin finds the guys inside an actual laboratory, and based on their super funky lab coat they potentially filmed in the future, where they used induction to heat up the copper to 1,200 degrees Celsius, which they then poured out and filmed with their super slow motion camera. Because they wanted to keep the quality of the footage higher, they only filmed it at 1,000 frames per second, as opposed to the much slower rates they often use. But it was more than enough to get some truly stunning visuals, which highlight the drastic changes heat can make to a substance's properties. In their first pour, the molten copper looked as fluid as orange soda, hitting the metal base the same way a spilled cola can would hit your kitchen floor, only if the soda could burn a hole in it. However, it was the second attempt, with the liquid copper itself as the only light source, that produced the real standout footage. The metal fell in perfect droplets, creating a glowing light show that feels like it should be shown in an art gallery. So forget ancient torture devices, because with our modern technology, something as dangerous as molten copper can be used to show the power and beauty of science. And if you're going to be handling some molten hot copper, you might want to have some thick skin. Or, you know, heavy gloves. But they didn't do a song called Heavy Gloves. So.
They fall like petals on a rose in the rain. We bloom in the shadow.
Monster. It was a powerful thing for our family to witness. A blind woman stumbles into an eye hospital in Kenya, and a few days later walks out to see her world.
Our family supports Operation Eyesight, a charitable organization that restores sight and helps prevent blindness in South Asia and Africa.
Our donation of $1 a day is enough to restore the sight of a blind person every month.
Visit OperationEyesight.ca. Are we making a difference? Just ask Chiku.
Because of me, she can see.
Motion Device from their YouTube channel. That was a piece of rock and roll. Want to follow them on YouTube? Pop on over to YouTube.com, of course. Official Motion Device, I believe, is their username. So go give that, or just search Motion Device. I'm sure you'll come across it. It'll come up one of the first things, you know, Official Motion Device. Follow or subscribe. That's the, yeah, follow is on Twitter. Anyway, they all have all the social media. All the websites that require person interaction have their own different word. So, this is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You're listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMR FM. When humans hunt, for the most part, it's admittedly not that exciting. There's a lot of covering yourself in animal urine and just waiting around. There's not a lot of stalking prey and waiting for your moment to pounce and face off one-on-one, beast versus beast. Now, I'm not much of a hunter personally, so excuse me if that's a misguided view of the subject. The point I'm trying to make is that when other animals hunt, there's a lot more at stake, and that makes the act a lot more intense. For instance, take a gander at this amazing video posted to Nerdist.com, shot from an eagle's point of view, which captures an adrenaline rush unlike any you've probably ever had. First, some context. These golden eagles are wrangled by Mongolian eagle hunters known as Brakichi, of which the New Yorker estimates there are only about 50 left. Eagles in tow, the Brakichi scan the landscape for foxes, and when they see one, they let their eagles go in hot pursuit. This time, though, they had GoPro cameras strapped to their backs, and as you'd imagine, that made for some pretty amazing footage. There's even one point in the video where it's paused to highlight the snarling expression made by the eagle's prey. Yeah, it's wild stuff. If this stuff is gripping you, you'll be pleased to hear that the video on Nerdist.com is actually just a trailer for a 15-minute film that's available on YouTube. There's also a 12-minute behind-the-scenes clip that provides cool insight into how this production came out. Check out both of those on Nerdist.com. And you can find that by going to Nerdist.com and searching POV video of an eagle hunting a fox is so intense. And meanwhile, while you're doing that, back to some motion device from their album Eternalize. Here is Breaking Through the Night.
Tell me what you see. Hello, I'm Ray Walsh. You're listening to 93.5 CHMR FM in St. John's, Newfoundland.
Thank you.
again from their album Eternalize, that's Motion Device with Changing Minds. And starting things off there was Breaking Through the Night. This is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You are listening to the Friday Morning Markout featuring Motion Device out of Ontario on CHMR 93.5 FM. It's been a long wait for Star Wars fans, but we finally find out what Luke Skywalker has to say to Rey when they meet for the first time at the beginning of The Last Jedi. And Luke's first words in The Last Jedi are, "Hey, do you happen to have a Slim Jim? Because I'm starving and there's, like, nothing to eat on this island." genuinely hilarious. That's not even his real life. It's real! I understand that reference. If only. In actuality, at Disney's annual shareholder meeting in Denver, it was revealed that his words are the more sensible, "Who are you?" But what should really stoke the excitement of fans is that the Disney chairman, Bob Iger, described the film at the meeting as, quote, "a perfect chapter in the iconic Skywalker family drama," unquote. So it sounds like there is indeed still a possibility that Rey could be the daughter of Luke or Leia. And then there's the sicko in me that says, why not both? And no, that's just no. And no. Before I go too far down that rabbit hole, let's get back to how Motion Device got famous in the first place by doing covers of classic metal and hard rock songs. So here's their rendition of Heaven and Hell. After that comment, I'm pretty sure I know which one I'm going to end up in. You know, in the event there's an actual god and he doesn't have a sense of humor. Or she doesn't have a sense of humor. Thanks, Kevin Smith.
Loco, if you're not listening to the Friday Morning Markout on CHMR 93.5 FM.
Kids, the evil forces of the Dark Emperor threaten the entire universe.
All right, let's get them.
But with the might of Nami O'Hara and her Japanese music and culture show at their side, they can't possibly lose. Fridays at 5 p.m. Newfoundland time, 3:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Listen online at chmr.ca.
Are you a sentimental old-timer and stuck in a vinyl groove? Or perhaps you're a newbie, eager to hear hard-to-find roots music of Newfoundland and Labrador? Whichever you are, check out the Newfound Records Radio Hour, Saturdays at noon on CHMR.
On a day when the sun is sleeping and only the sound of the wind is heard.
Are you ready for the best and the worst of wrestling music? Then check out Ring Rust every Friday afternoon at 1 for the best and the worst.
Are you ready for this? Cause if you all broke your fist like this,
are you ready?
Keep it going and going, we're gonna rock it, baby, all night long. Yeah,
we're gonna do the damn thing, so I hope you're ready. Savage Man's gonna rip the microphone like a baddie and rock steady. Should've never got me started in this rap game. Now you're dearly departed, that's regarded. A wrestler coming off like this, one that's lyrically inclined with a mic in his fist.
Hi, I'm Jerry Stamp, and you're listening to CHMR 93.5 FM.
I'm a marathon man. I can't believe that I'm still running, but here I am.
When I was a kid, if someone brandished a shrink gun, he'd get a little bit of respect.
Yes! Yes! Mind taking! Stick with the kid, baby!
I wanna rock!
Rizak out with your Kizak out. You're listening to the Friday Morning Markout on CHMR 93.5 FM.
Tell me not to play, but all I gotta say to when you tell me not to play, I say no!
No, 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 no!
Thank you.
Were you hearing that too? Just listen to the lyrics of that and let's just all assume cute little 15-year-old Sarah's only singing about bringing home a six-stringer. Starting things off with Heaven and Hell. Once again, where I might end up going. One of those two. So, this is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You're for having those. You're listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMR FM. Moving swiftly along. It can be mind-boggling to think about how long cartoons have been around. Yes, Mickey Mouse has been an American pop culture icon for longer than virtually everybody hearing these words has been alive. Believe it or not, the history of animation goes back a lot farther than that. Pre-film, the first animations can be tracked back to 1833 with the zoetrope. It only evolved from that point on, and this rich history is what the video posted to Nerdist.com from the Solomon Society beautifully demonstrates. Early animation was often primitive and minimalistic. What's surprising is how quickly it starts to achieve a level of fluidity similar to modern cartoons. By the early 1900s, films like Gertie the Dinosaur from 1914 demonstrated movement that looked pretty natural. Disney's Flowers and Trees is the first color film included in the video, and as you'd expect, there's a lot more Disney after that. Even though we knew that Snow White is super old, it's crazy to think that it came out 80 years ago in 1937, because of how well done it was. The video only covers 1833 to 1990, since its creator wrote in the description that, quote, the 3D revolution deserves its own video, unquote. While the video is presented beautifully, it's worth noting that it's far from a complete history. As one YouTube commentator put it, quote, UPA, Warner Brothers, Fleischer, Terry Toons, Jay Ward, etc., so many omissions. The work of Richard Williams and other Japanese studios outside of Ghibli, unquote. Again, go on over to Nerdist.com and search out Explore the Beautiful History of 2D Animation and check out that video. But after, of course, you finish listening to the Friday Morning Markout with some more awesome motion device out of Ontario. One-Eyed Jack.
Oh, when you wish.
When you wish for something wonderful to happen.
What is the power of a wish?
Sometimes it can make you forget
about the needles and the pain
and get through this thing.
Wishes are what we do.
Forget about being stuck inside.
Laugh with my family.
Go somewhere really amazing and get through this thing.
The Children's Wish Foundation of Canada. Call 1-888-267-WISH or visit childrenswish.ca today.
Electric eye, but hey. Motion Device did a pretty good job of Another Thing Coming, as done by Judas Priest from their album Screaming for Vengeance, but from Motion Device's YouTube channel.
Like me on Facebook, tinyurl.com/ringrust. Follow me on Twitter at Mark Jabroni. And subscribe to Jabronology TV, youtube.com/fanboymarkjabroni.
Featuring Andrea Minidakis on keyboards, that was Motion Device, or I guess more specifically it's Andrea from Motion Device, because not like it's the whole band, but not going to really complain, with Restless Heart. This is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You are listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMRFM. After a long hiatus, iZombie is finally back, and just like a zombie, fans have been starving for brain content. The tales of crime-solving zombie about town Liv Moore have been gone too long, and fans have been as anxious as a just-bitten human to find out what's next for the team. iZombie is known for its detailed depictions of not only how zombies consume, but also how they cook. Some fans don't watch television like a normal person. They take notes. Meticulous notes detailing all the food that's being shown on screen and why. And of all the shows that incorporate food into their storylines, iZombie does an impressive job exploring characters' eating habits. You'd be surprised to know that all the iZombie food scenes that show prep, cooking, and serving from start to finish are only about 8 to 10 seconds long. But within those few seconds, the viewers are still able to get a clear idea of what Liv is making and how it's going to taste. While there have been many brilliant brain recipes from the past two seasons, these are the top five as far as creativity and craveability. And I'm not going to go through the whole thing. You can just pop on over to the Nerdist.com page and search out iZombie's best brain recipes for the zombie in need and check out the list right there. And meantime, let's go back to Motion Device, shall we? Doves and Snakes. We'll be right back.
Everybody, this is Rocky Rashad, and you're tuned to St. John's only music alternative, 93.5 CHMR FM.
Last in Line and Stand Up and Shout. Motion Device from their YouTube channel. This is Fatmore Mark Cervoni. You are listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMR FM. I'd like to take a moment to send a shout out to one of the members of the Motion Device Warriors Facebook page. Gunny, who used to be a weapons tech in the military. So she was right there in the front lines, even though she wasn't fighting, but she was allowing other people to do the fighting by fixing their weapons and their equipment and stuff. And so she's quite the warrior, and she's a motion device warrior. So glad to hear that you stood your ground.
yeah. Ones and twos, DJ Tesla, smooth poet repping soul deep in GSC. On the morning flow, yeah. CHMR, 93.5 FM, keep it light. You got the smooth poet and Mark Jaboni, yeah.
Tune in to Modern Jazz Today, a weekly show that focuses on today's jazz improvisers and creators, cutting their teeth and cutting the edge of sound. Join us as we explore what's new, what's groundbreaking, and where it's happening. Mondays from 2 to 4 p.m. on CHMR 93.5 FM.
In our continuing efforts to bring you unique and innovative programming and to help stem the tide of mindless pop-oriented AM drivel, Mun Radio proudly announces the return of a Monday Night Classic, a show that will bring a little dignity and refinement to your FM radio dial. Yes, if you're looking for some classic radio, tune in to 93.5 CHMR FM every Monday, 7 to 9 p.m. for Cosmic Debris. It's your weekly fix of sex, drugs, and rock and roll on the radio. Every Monday, 7 to 9 p.m., it's Cosmic Debris. Only on 93.5 CHMR FM.
Heterosexual Cavalcade of Uber Swank. Fridays at 3 p.m., 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard. Listen live on CHMR 93.5 FM, Alliance 787, Cable 942, or via the internet at www.chmr.ca.
This is Naya from Heliotropes, and you're listening to 93.5 CHMR FM, Newfoundland's only alternative.
Uh-oh, moving! Ow, pointy! Ew, slimy.
Woohoo!
Gotta go up!
No!
Hello, my friends. We're back again to the Markout on CHMR 93.5 FM.
Oh, my hoping.
So long.
Motion Device from their album Eternalize with We'll Meet Again. And before starting things off there, Stand Your Ground. Shout out for Gunny from the Motion Device Warriors Facebook page. This is Fanboy Mark Jabroni. You're listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMRFM. Thor Ragnarok may be 8 months away from striking theaters, but the God of Thunder is rocking the cover of EW this week alongside Tessa Thompson's Valkyrie and Cate Blanchett as Hela. Or Hela? The Asgardian goddess of death and ruler of hell. With one L. You know, hell, Hela? Anyway, the first thing you may have noticed is that Thor's signature blonde locks have been cut short, and he's traded in Mjolnir for a pair of swords. But there may be more to Thor's new look than meets the eye, and this edition of Nerdist News is breaking down the latest info about Thor Ragnarok. Join host and heir to the old strong power, Jessica Chabot, as she takes a closer look at the Odinson's change in appearance. As much as we're digging Thor's makeover, we can't help but think that it may not have been something that he chose for himself. We already know that the film is partially inspired by the famous Planet Hulk storyline, and that Mark Ruffalo's Bruce Banner slash Incredible Hulk will already be fighting in the gladiatorial games by the time that Thor gets there. Perhaps Thor's new haircut was meant as a way to humiliate the son of Odin as he is forced into the life of a slave. But that's probably a bad idea for anyone, even Jeff Goldblum's Grandmaster. So, pop on over to Nerdist.com and search out what Thor's new look means for Ragnarok and give that video a look. But after you listen to the song that really did it for me and probably any countless other people who are now big fans of Motion Device, when a website, I don't remember which website it was, posted a video of this band of kids doing a cover of a Black Sabbath classic song. So, I don't remember what the website was, but I do certainly remember what the song was. War Pigs on 93.5 CHMRFM. I believe Sarah was 11 at the time that this was recorded. So, sit there and be amazed.
darkness world stops turning. Ashes where the body's burning. No more war pigs have the power. Hand of God has struck the hour. Day of judgment, God is calling. War pigs crawling, begging mercies for the sins. Satan laughing spreads his wings. Oh, not ya!
On Facebook, tinyurl.com/RayRust. Follow me on Twitter at Mark Jabroni. And subscribe to Jabronology TV, youtube.com/FanboyMarkJabroni.
Oh, we-
Motion Device from their album Eternal Eyes. This is Fairmore Mark Jabroni. You are listening to the Friday Morning Markout on 93.5 CHMR FM. Feel free to pop on over to the event page, Motion Device on the Friday Morning Markout, and find out when I'm going to be rescheduling the event page for this. Be sometime in June when I'll be doing this again. So if you want to find out more about Motion Device, pop on over to their website, motiondevice.net. You can find out about their Kickstarter campaign to get their new album done, which they've exceeded expectations, actually, on that. So congratulations to them. I have my copy of it coming, well, when it's printed. I have an advanced copy reserved, and I think I'm getting one of those medallions, too, I think, for, we'll see. Anyway, they do have my name down as a contributor. It's just that every other contributor seemed to be getting a shout-out, and anyway, motiondevice.net, find out more about this great band, find out where you can order Eternal Eyes, where you can actually get in on the Kickstarter if you want to get a copy of their upcoming album. You know, when it comes out, you can get it sent right to you, and there you go. So, closing things off for Eternal Eyes, here is Be the Light. And of course, pop on over to their YouTube channel. Just do search for Motion Device on YouTube.
that's it for another show, kiddies. Check me out on Facebook, where you can keep track of all the news that's right on the mark, from around ringside to the latest concerts. See you at the shows. Later days.